Do not listen to this recording whilst driving or operating machinery, or if you suffer from epilepsy. Only listen when you can relax safely and completely. If you have difficulty falling asleep from time to time, or quite often, or if you are waking up during the night, then this recording is for you. You can lie down and listen to the sound of my voice, while I guide you into a more pleasant and relaxed state of mind. So you can drift off comfortably, while I give you some positive suggestions to your subconscious mind that can help you sleep and get into a better sleeping pattern, so you can fall asleep much faster than before and sleep soundly through the night without waking up. And you can listen to this recording as many times as you need to learn how to fall asleep easier, like you have done in the past, but may have forgotten how to over time. How to fall asleep easier and stay asleep through the night, so you can wake up feeling refreshed and energized. If you haven't been sleeping well because there is something that is worrying you, or if you are carrying in your mind a list of things you need to do or remember, then I can suggest for you to pause the recording and write down whatever it is that is on your mind, so you can download it from your busy mind onto a sheet of paper or a journal, and then put it aside where you can deal with it tomorrow, and put it out of your mind for now, because this is your time to relax now, and you can relax here and now. As you listen, my voice can lull you to sleep. And you can begin by taking in 3 big, deep breaths. And with each breath, breathe in all the way, filling your lungs. Hold to the count of 3 and just let each breath fall out of your chest on its own, just naturally. And don't force it in any way. You can go ahead and do that now. And as you do, just allow your body to become loose, limp, and relaxed. And as you become loose, limp, and relaxed, you can just watch your thoughts float by. Some people have a very busy mind, and busy minds tend to be preoccupied with thoughts that just rise up like bubbles out of nowhere. And sometimes it seems like there are racing thoughts that collide into other racing thoughts. It can be hard to know where one thought starts and ends and another one begins. And sometimes people identify with their thoughts. I'd like you to know that you are not your thoughts. Yes, that's right. You are not your thoughts. Your thoughts are only a product of your busy mind. And your mind can make thoughts, and your mind can slow down all those busy thoughts. until they can slowly fade away into the background on their own. Your mind can become bored with making busy thoughts when there is something else to focus on. I'd like you to consider a simple idea, and that is that certain mindful thoughts can push out the unwanted thoughts. Because you can't think two different kinds of thoughts at the same time. So I wonder if you'd like to play along with this idea. As you listen to my voice now, and just for a few moments, that you turn your attention to your body and become aware of your physical body. Any physical sensations in your body that can keep you grounded in the present moment. You can become mindful of how your body feels, how you are breathing, how your body feels lying in bed, feeling supported by your bed, the feeling of softness and comfort, the weight of your bed covers, the temperature of your body, the temperature around you, the sound of your breathing, the feeling of your heart beating, the sensation of air entering your lungs, and the sound of your breathing. You can notice your stomach and chest rising and falling with each breath in and each breath out. Noticing any tension in your body and letting it go. There is so much that you can be aware of that can help to relax you, because you have taken your focus off your busy thoughts just by being aware and mindful of your body. And the simplest and easiest thing to do is to focus on your breathing, because you are breathing all the time and you can easily notice it if you are mindful. And you can notice yourself noticing that you are breathing, and breathing is relaxing and can calm the body. And noticing your breathing can be relaxing too. And any time that you find yourself having any other thoughts, just remember to bring your awareness back to your body. And keep your awareness on your body. And maintain your focus on your breathing. Just keep breathing in and breathing out naturally, and maintain your focus on your breathing, because maintaining your focus on your breathing can relax you and allow you to fall asleep easily and naturally. It doesn't matter right now if your eyes are open or closed. If they are closed, that's fine. And if they are open, that's fine too. There is plenty of time for your mind to make that decision. Whether your eyes will become tired and your eyelids will close down, or stay open a little longer. but only as long as is fine with your subconscious mind to do so. And while you are deciding what to do, or what you should do, or what you'd like to do, about your eyes being closed and staying closed, I'd like to ask you to play a game of imagination with me. However you like to imagine is just fine. Some people prefer to close their eyes to imagine, and some people like to have their eyes open and defocus their eyes when they imagine. Either way, an image can be created. And it's up to you how you'd like to do that now. So right now, I wonder if you can imagine that your thoughts are like the hands on a clock, turning around in circles very fast. And in your imagination, I want you to imagine a clock just like that, with a black frame around it, a very large clock on a wall, and you're very close to it. And allow the clock to slow down more and more so that it's comfortable for you to watch it. With the hands turning around and around like an animation. And everyone knows that the big hand turns faster on any clock, while the small hand turns slower. So that it takes a whole hour to change from one number to the next number, and the next number, and so on. And right now, I want you to ignore the big hand on that clock, like it's not even there. And just focus on the small hand, which is turning slowly, barely moving at all. And while it barely moves at all, from time to time, you will notice the large hand crosses under it, and that's the only time you can notice it. And that takes a whole hour. And every hour seems to stretch longer and longer. And the reason that every hour passes slower and slower is because time can slow down as your thoughts slow down. Because you are relaxing now, deeper and deeper, deeper than before. And I want you to focus on the small hand on the clock again and notice how you can no longer notice that it's moving because it makes your eyes so tired to watch, even if it's just in your imagination. And you would much rather be resting than thinking about anything at all. And with your eyes closed, I want you to keep imagining that you are looking at that clock. Now just allow that image to slowly push out further and further, as though it's zooming further away in slow motion. And keep pushing it out, only as slow as is comfortable for you, until it's just a small dot and the wall is far away in the distance and time just doesn't matter anymore. And it doesn't matter what the time is, as long as there is time to relax. And you are relaxing now. Relaxing is good for the body and good for your mind. And while you are relaxing, perhaps I can tell you a story that I once heard. There is an old story about a young man who travelled to a faraway land in search of adventure. He enjoyed learning about foreign cultures, and he was a writer, looking to learn new things to write about. When he got there, he didn't have much money left, and he could barely speak the language, but pretty soon he found a place to stay, and he found some modest employment. He made some new friends, and life was very peaceful in the village, and life was good. Since he was always good at learning new things and adapting, pretty soon he settled into a new way of life. His philosophy was that we can all learn new things, and learning is what life is all about. And he also liked to share his stories with other people. And that's why he became a writer. He soon found a job as a gardener, and he enjoyed planting seeds and seedlings and watching them slowly grow. He found his efforts both rewarding and relaxing. After each day's work, he would swim in the river and wash off all the dirt and sweat and enjoy the sunset before dinner. Just watching the ripples in the water shimmer with the last of the pink and gold sunset. And life was good and peaceful. After the harvest, he moved on to the next town and wondered what he might do next. He decided that he wanted to learn how to be a shepherd and find out how shepherds lived and learn how to take care of sheep and sleep under the stars. Soon he found a farmer who had a flock of sheep and was in need of a new shepherd after the old shepherd became old and could no longer walk far. He knew that life as a shepherd would be peaceful and quiet. And although it didn't pay much, he would have plenty of time on his hands to write about all his recent adventures, and after 12 months or so, he would have many books to sell when he returned home. Week after week, he lived the same routine, which he enjoyed because it was a new experience to have the same routine every day and every night. He would herd the sheep from one green pasture to the next and spend the afternoons and evenings writing down his ideas and thoughts about life. And at night he would count the stars and think of home and his family. Even though he loved his travel and adventures, he missed his family sometimes. He thought fondly about his mother's cooking and remembered all the bedtime stories she read to him as a child. He thought about his older brother who was married and worked on the family farm, and sometimes wondered if he would find someone to marry when he returned home one day. He would lie awake at night and try and imagine what his future wife would look like. Would she be pretty? Would she have long, shiny hair and soft skin? Would she enjoy listening to his stories? How many children would they have? And he thought about the names that he would give them. While gazing at the stars, he would give the stars names, one by one, as though they were his future children. The first star was Mary. The second star was Patrick. The third star was James. The fourth star was Elizabeth. The fifth star was John. The sixth star was Jeremy. And when he had seven names and eight names and then 9 names, he would continue to think of more names until he had 10 names. And then he would keep going and keep naming the stars until he named 20, and then 30, then 40, and then it was 50 and 60, and all the way to 70, and then 80. And each time he counted more stars and named them, he would do so slower and slower, because after a while he would get so tired and sleepy, and he would run out of names. And it became hard to remember which names he had already chosen and which ones he hadn't. And it soon became so tiring. He would slowly rub his tired, burning eyes and yawn several times before he could go on. Some nights he reached 90 names while counting 90 stars, and other times he reached 91 and 92, but it was always the same. His eyes would strain to stay open, and he could not stay awake, and he would tiredly drift off into a restful sleep before he could reach 100. The next day, he would wake up feeling refreshed and ready to begin a new day and take the sheep to new pastures and meadows and explore new hills and valleys, enjoying the fresh air and being in nature, eating wholesome food, drinking fresh water from creeks and streams, feeling healthy and getting gentle exercise, and sometimes enjoying the company and conversation of other village folk who he crossed paths with as he went from one place to the next. He would always find a small village or country homestead where he could buy fresh food and milk and home-cooked meals. After 1 month passed slowly, and then the second month came around, and then the third month, and by the time the fourth and fifth month passed, he already had a backpack full of stories. But he had so much more that he wanted to write. So he happily spent the sixth month writing, and then the seventh month, the eighth month, and by this time he was already on his way back to the farmer because it was time to return. So in the ninth and tenth month, he more or less had most of his stories written down on paper, while he noticed that the seasons were changing and the weather was cooling. And at night, all he wanted to do was snuggle further and further into his sleeping bag and sleep longer and longer, all the way through the night, while the sheep huddled together for warmth. And as the 11th month approached, he realized that he was almost back at the farm once again. By looking at the changing seasons and noticing that it was winter again, and judging by the landscape, he was almost there. When he finally returned back to the farm after 12 months, he was very tired and had no more stories left in his mind. They were all on paper now, and his head was clear. And now he felt it was time to take a long rest, and was pleased to once again sleep in a warm, comfortable bed with a soft pillow and soft sheets and soft woolen blankets. while the cold winter wind whistled through the cracks in the windows and the cottage door rattled from the howling winter winds. He no longer slept under the stars, but some nights he could see them through the window when the sky was clear enough. There was still work to be done on the farm for 2 more months. And when the beginning of spring returned, it was time for him to collect his final wages and set off in search of new work, more exciting new adventures, and to plan his trip back home. As he set off for the next town to get a carriage ride to the nearest port, the rain set in. He was ready to go home and had a backpack full of stories that he had written that he planned to sell to a publishing house back home. He also had a leather pouch full of money that he wanted to spend on a plot of land back home to start his own farm back home and marry and live a settled life. But the heavy rain caused all the roads to become quagmires with potholes, and there was no way to get through with the carriage. The horses and the carriage were becoming bogged in the thick mud. So the coachman had to turn him out at the nearest homestead, where he paid for a room and his dinner. After 2 days, it still rained. After 3 and 4 days, it still rained. The downpipes could not hold all the heavy water, and they creaked and sagged and leaked. The rain covered the grass entirely, and the splashy wet sounds became constant. There was rain and more rain. Whether it was light rain or medium rain or heavy rain, it didn't matter. It just rained the entire time. It rained for days and it rained for weeks. No more carriages went past the homestead, and everything was still outside. The horses and the chickens and the pigs and all the other farm animals seemed content with all the rain, calm and relaxed and sleepy. The dog slept all day and night. The cat slept all day and night. The farmer slept all night and dozed during the day. Sometimes he snored quietly and sometimes he snored loudly. The farmer's wife slept all day, except for when she potted around the house and baked bread. The farm workers had not been called in to work because of the rain. Everything was quiet and peaceful. It was a little boring, but in a comforting way. And since there was nothing at all to do, the young man also slept. There was nothing to do but sleep. All his stories had been written down on paper, so there was nothing to write. All his wages had been earned, and there was no more work to do. And when the rain stopped, when they were ready, he knew he could travel home, but for now there was no work to do. So sleep was the only answer. There was nothing to do but sleep and listen to the sound of the rain, beginning with light sleep, and when it's too light, going into a deeper sleep. Going deeper and deeper, deeper down, all the way down. The eyelids can flutter when you dream, dreaming about pastures and meadows. gentle flowing creeks and trickling streams, birds gliding across peaceful blue skies, colourful butterflies fluttering in the breeze. Sleeping and dreaming of faraway places, softly, soundly, peacefully, as the rain falls to the wet ground, splashes on the wet porch, splatters on the roof, full drain pipes gushing with rainwater. Everything being washed, cleansed, and renewed. As the rain falls and falls, it becomes easier and easier to go into a deep sleep. A renewing sleep. Your body is resting and replenishing. Your mind is resting and recovering and learning how to sleep better, how to sleep soundly through the night, learning how to fall asleep and stay asleep as long as you need to stay asleep so that you feel better, have more energy, have more vitality. Enjoy your energy the next day. All of your body is relaxed completely now, loose and limp, more relaxed than ever, from the top of your head to the tips of your toes, feeling heavier and heavier in a deep, deep sleep. And you are comfortable just as you are, lying there in a deep sleep. And your body wants to sleep and rest, and your mind wants to sleep and rest. You can sleep deeply and soundly. That's right. And you can sleep deeply and soundly every night. From this night forth, you will fall asleep easily and quickly whenever you go to bed. You will sleep through the night and stay asleep for as long as your body wants to rest. For as long as you know you need to sleep. Anytime you go to bed, you can let go of any thoughts that keep you from sleeping soundly. Thoughts can always wait until the next day, when it's a better time to deal with them. Your subconscious mind will remind you the next day when something is important. So that for this time and every night from now on, you can sleep better. I want you to thank your subconscious mind for allowing you to get the rest that you need right now. Deep, restful sleep that is beneficial to you in every way. And any time that you go to bed, you will soon feel a pleasant drowsiness taking over, and very soon after going to bed, you will feel sleepier and sleepier with each minute that that passes by. This is a place where you can enjoy deep, restful sleep every night. And I'm going to count backwards from 100. And with each number that I count, you can go deeper and deeper into a restful sleep. Deeper and deeper still, letting go completely, continuing to sleep until the morning, feeling wonderful the next day.
61 62 63 64 63 62 61 6
energy. Fifty-nine, fifty-eight, fifty-seven. Fifty-six, fifty-five, fifty-four, fifty-three, fifty-two. 51, 50, 49, 48, 47. 46, 45, 44, 43, 42. 41, 40, 39, 38, 37. 36, 35, 34, 33, 32. 31, 30, 29, 28, 27. 26, 25, 24, 23, 22. 21, 20, 19, 18, 17. 16, 15, 14, 13, 12. 11. Three, two,